Ever since they were young and flourishing into life, with nothing but prosperity and family honor in their minds, Chinese people wanted to come to America and live the American dream that everyone believed in. Children, teens, adults, and elders all wanted to prosper and have a better life. In 1849, the California Gold Rush appeared to be the answer to their search for prosperity. Later, in the 1960s, Chinese found another working opportunity when the Central Pacific Railroad recruited laborers to build a portion of the Transcontinental Railroad. Therefore, many Chinese people came to America in pursuit of fortune. At first, when gold was plentiful, the Chinese were tolerated. But as it became limited, the Americans felt that the Chinese were a competition in their economy. Thus, they were forcibly driven out from the mines to settle in Chinese enclaves, mainly San Francisco, to work in low-wage jobs as restaurant or laundry workers. For this reason, the American government passed the Chinese Exclusion Act that was signed by President Chester A. Arthur in 1882. The act provided an absolute 10-year moratorium on Chinese labor immigration. The Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882 restricted the free immigration of Chinese people to the U.S., made them permanent aliens by excluding them from U.S. citizenship, and prevented the Chinese community from growing and assimilating in the U.S. as European immigrants once did.
Firstly, and most importantly, the Chinese Exclusion Acts restricted Chinese free immigration to the U.S. Since Chinese laborers originally came to the U.S. for opportunities that arose from the gold rush and railroad construction, the 1882 Act defined and stereotyped them as skilled and unskilled laborers and Chinese employed in mining. Yet, because the U.S. government did not want the Chinese to come to the U.S. for gold mining, any Chinese labor was restricted to immigrate to the U.S. based on that stereotype. In addition, those who were not laborers had to get certification from the Chinese government that they were allowed to immigrate. However, it was difficult to prove that one was not a laborer, because the entire Chinese society had been stereotyped as laborers. These hardships made life and the dream of prosperity for the Chinese very harsh and difficult.
Apart from restricting the Chinese from immigration to the U.S., the Exclusion Acts also made Chinese permanent aliens by excluding them from U.S. citizenship. Those individuals who did not have U.S. citizenship could easily be deported by state and federal courts. In order not to return to their homeland, the Chinese kept quiet and worked as low-wage workers, cleaning at restaurants or laundry rooms and not fighting for their own rights. Moreover, since citizenship was not given to the Chinese people, they could not petition any of their family members to come to the U.S. Therefore, it was very difficult for Chinese to reunite with their family and live a prosperous new beginning in their new homes. Many faced such suffering and were prevented from having appropriate American citizenship and from seeing their families whom they loved the most.
Restrictions of U.S. citizenship were not the only cases that were established by Chinese Exclusion Acts, but also the inability of the Chinese community to grow and assimilate in American society as the Europeans did. Since only restricted to work at low-wage occupations, the Chinese people did not have the ability to follow their dreams and accomplish the great wealth and better life that they really wanted when they initially immigrated to the U.S. Also, many Chinese were discriminated from Americans and Europeans who claimed to say that the Chinese society was lowering their wages. many of the Chinese customs and traditions were violated. They were insulted, imprisoned, beaten, and in some cases even killed. By attacking the Chinese, most Europeans who had suffered from Eastern nativism were able to higher their own status and probably increase their own wage. For these reasons, the Chinese were discriminated and could not grow and prosper in their new land, America.
The Chinese Exclusion Acts was passed in 1882 and lasted 10 years. After that, and for the same reasons, Congress passed the Geary Act, which extended the act for another 10 years until the Extension Act of 1904. That act was made permanent that there cannot be any immigration to the US by Chinese people. While it was true that Chinese were banned from entering the United States for over 60 years, on December 17, 1943, because Japan bombed Pearl Harbor, that fact changed when the US Congress passed the Chinese Exclusion Repeal Act, which permitted the Chinese to enter the United States once again. The Chinese Exclusion Act was repealed mainly for political rather than human rights reasons. Since China had been enemies with Japan when World War II broke out, Chinese became allies to the United States. To keep sentiments between China and the US high, Congress repealed the Chinese Exclusion Act. Most Chinese and Chinese Americans felt this was a victory for all. However, until today, the American reputation remains tainted by its inhumane exclusions and racist policies that were established towards the Chinese in the later 19th and early part of the 20th century.
The Chinese, fallen behind politically and socially, came to the US to have a better life. However, they ended up coming to America to find discrimination. Set up by the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882, the Chinese society was not permitted to immigrate to the US, have American citizenship, or grow and assimilate as a Chinese American society in their new home. Throughout the years, they were seen differently than the rest of the American society. The Chinese people did go through a lot of discrimination, trial, and hardships from the US, yet they stood strong, protected their families, persevered, and lived with what they had. As it goes in a Chinese proverb, no matter how the wind howls, the mountain will not bow to it.